Today we will discuss one very important topic, which is thermoregulation. Newborns need some support for their thermoregulation, whether it be skin to skin care with the mother, keeping the environmental or room temperature adjusted, or in the case of a premature baby, additional support from the radiant warmer or the incubator. So why exactly do we need temperature support and why do we need support for thermoregulation? So the main factor is that if the baby doesn't maintain the temperature and goes in for hypothermia, there is an increased risk of morbidity. And hypothermia can affect the baby in different ways. The blood sugar may not be maintained because their energy consumption is more when they are cold. Their hemodynamic stability, the blood pressure and other parameters may be affected. The baby may become quieter and may not feed as well as they should. And in addition, the risk of infections is increased because your immune system doesn't function as well when you're cold. So it's very important to monitor right from the time of birth, right from the labor room temperature, and support the baby through it. We have a concept in terms of thermoregulation called thermoneutral zone. And thermoneutral zone is nothing but the temperature range or the ambient parameters, the settings which affect the baby's temperature in such a way that the baby maintains a normal temperature without extra expenditure of energy. So we do have ways in which the body can increase the metabolism and can generate heat, for example, through brown fat. If these are used, the baby is actually consuming energy to maintain the temperature. So this is not ideal and this is not what we are aiming for. And this is the range. So the when I say ambient conditions, it includes the temperature settings in the environment, the clothing status of the baby, whether there is any air movement because a wind draught will cool the baby, and whether there is any other parameter like if the baby is under radiant warmer, there is evaporation or insensible losses as well, which we need to counter. So these parameters together form the thermoneutral zone, and we need to look at all the aspects of this when we are deciding on the type of temperature support that the baby needs. The other concept that you need to understand is something called cold stress. So I mentioned that the baby can maintain the temperature range with expenditure of energy. So this is additional settings that happens in the baby, additional changes that happen in the baby to enable the baby to maintain the temperature. This can be in the form of vasoconstriction or narrowing of the blood vessels in the periphery. And this means if we have cold hands and feet, because the blood supply to the periphery drops, more blood coming into the center of the body, and it's the central temperature or the core temperature that the brain tries to maintain. The hypothalamus and other centers of the brain have a central role, and the autonomic nervous system or the sympathetic parasympathetic nervous system also supports this. So you have cold feet and prolonged capillary filling in the peripheries may be seen as well. The baby's axillary temperature or the core temperature that you measure will still be normal. So if you notice this, it means that the baby is actually expending energy and you need to give more temperature support to maintain the temperature. So don't be satisfied with what you're doing, you need to support more. When it comes to a normal term baby, there are two or three things that you can do to make sure that the baby is stabilized. Obviously, the baby is coming from the womb wet, and you need to receive the baby in a warm, dry environment. You receive the baby with the labor room temperature set as per the NRP at 24 to 25 degrees. The obstetricians may not like this, but we need to educate the team that it is in the best interest of the baby not to keep the labor room temperature too cold. The other important parameter is if the baby needs additional support, the best way to support the baby, if you feel the hands and feet, you can teach the mother as well. Look at the hands and feet of the baby. If baby is a bit colder, you need to rewarm the baby and wrap the baby more after that. So remember that wrapping the baby with additional layers of clothing doesn't give extra heat. Clothing insulates the baby and it retains the heat which the baby has already. So the heat loss is reduced, but it doesn't give heat. So if the baby is actually in cold stress or is cold, you need to rewarm the baby. And the easiest way is skin to skin care. We start it right from birth. It's one of the principles of baby friendly initiative as well. So we have to hold the baby skin to skin and recheck the temperature after some time. If needed, you may have to keep the baby under a heated cot or a radiant warmer for a brief time to bring the temperature up. If a baby is at risk of hypothermia, like a baby who has respiratory distress or who is hypoglycemic already, or who has gone through a strain around delivery like perinatal asphyxia, we need to monitor these babies more closely. So this is one point that we should educate all the mothers. If you feel the baby is cold, hold the baby skin to skin, bring the baby's temperature up, and then wrap the baby more to maintain it. And obviously a thermometer to regularly check the temperature at home is not essential. When you educate the parents, you can say that usually the baby maintains the temperature well, and if you have concerns, feel the hands and feet. Of course, fever is more significant, and if the baby feels unduly warm, you need to take the baby for a physician review, even if it may be just dehydration fever in the beginning. Moving on to thermoregulation in the NICU. So we have different equipment to help, and most of these babies who come to the NICU are either sick babies because they have respiratory distress, birth asphyxia, and so on, or they are premature babies. A premature baby is at risk of temperature related problems because their skin is very immature and thin. They are prone for high insensible water losses. Their posture is extended, so they are going to have more surface of the body exposed. The ratio of their weight to surface area is significantly higher. So the surface area is much more compared to the weight of the baby because the baby is fairly thin. So all these factors play a role in why we need extra attention. And I mentioned the important point about immunity and temperature control. Nutrition also plays a role. And if the baby expends energy in maintaining the temperature, they're not going to gain weight very well. So this is another factor to look at.